What person gets only 3 or 4 hours sleep and tends to put makeup on and make a video? You guess who? Everybody, welcome back to my channel. This is gonna be Best of Beauty 2016 for makeup. And since y'all already seen hair care, I know that was pretty of a long video, and I'm just gonna go through this pretty quickly so we can get on. So I can get on with my next video for lips. And so let's get on with it, shall we? So, the first thing I have been reaching for the past year, which I got it last year at Ross, which is this Glamorous Blush 10 Color Blush Palette. And let me tell you, I just like completely love this blush palette. I still keep the film on it so it doesn't get, you know, dirty or whatever. But it comes with all different kind of colors for like nudes and everything. And for like, I mean, they're very, very pigmented. Let me see if I can do a swatch for y'all. So y'all can see how pigmented it is. See how pigmented that is? Yeah. So if you know, brush lightly. I'm just going to brush it there and that because I have no makeup remover wipes and that. So, I mean, they're all very pigmented. You just, you know, build up as much as you want. Mostly what I do is I just put it like right here and that. I mean, especially when it's summertime, I use mostly these colors and that. And then when it gets, you know, to spring, you can still use like these colors or you could add these colors and everything very, very lightly. And it comes out beautifully and that, and they blend very well. And that, so that's that. I'm gonna wash my hands later. Next thing I've been reaching for is this Wet n Wild Fergie, which I know this has really been my kind of like if I want to have like a glow look and everything. And it's very, very pigmented. And I'm gonna do a swatch real here, see if I can swatch it on my hand. I mean, you can barely see it, and I mean, yeah, you can see just very, very low. It's right there, and that, but when you actually, like, really, like, build it up, let's see if I can swatch it here, and that, yeah, you can barely see it, because I'm not really facing the light and everything, so, yeah, this is usually what I usually grab for if I want that just nice natural look on my face and that. So yeah, it's very like not too like blinding, if you know what I mean. This next which is Mary Lou Mananizer, which I ordered this off of eBay and that. And when I first tried it and everything, you have to really like build up the color and everything. And I'm going to try to see if I, it's very, very sheer. Y'all can see that. It's like right there. And and usually, you know, after a while you build up some more and everything. It comes out very beautifully. It's kind of like on my finger right there, on my ring finger. Yeah, it has like that little sheen to it. And I really like that, highlight. And this one, oh my gosh, I told, you can smell without even opening it. Oh my gosh. By Fiskin's Formula. And that, oh my gosh. And of course it has, this one I use like sometime for the summer or if I just want to look like have a glowy look, you know, like a bronze glowy look and everything. I really love this palette. It plus it smells so good. It smells like perfume. Oh, gonna kill me. Oh gosh. This next one I always use and also comes with a highlight as well, which is the City Color Contouring Palette, which also has, you know, two different contouring shades and a highlight. And I always reach for this when I'm doing my contour-ish, you know. And it works pretty well. I'm not wearing it today because I'm trying to get this video up for y'all. And so I'm not really going anywhere. So, all right. Next thing I have been grabbing for sometime if I feel like I want like a natural eye look and everything, this Playboy HD Color Trio Eyeshadow. And which are very, very pigmented as well. And sometimes I use the brown color, which is right here. Which is, see how pigmented it is? And I'm gonna grab this kind of like a silvery shade. You can barely see that. I mean, it's very, very light. Using, you put that like right on the lid. And this one right here is like for the highlight. That's how pigmented it is right there. And if I swatch it on my hand, which you could barely see it, but when you put on your eyelids, girl, you be banging like a bang million bucks with this look. And that great. Put it on the other side of the comforter because it's got brown on it. Okay, let's get into the. Ooh, I'm itchy. These palettes I've had for a long time, but just never, sometimes I'll grab for them, which this is the Tone Correcting Powder, and I came with to try their new correcting powder or cream, whatever they have out now, and I haven't really touched it anymore since I've already hit pan, but yeah, it's been a very good palette. And this one, oh my god, when I first was using this, I don't remember exactly when. I used to have like I think I have an e.l.f. haul video, which I'll probably put it somewhere here. And this one, I was like, oh my gosh, I totally love this palette and everything because I could look bronzy, you know, especially for that summer look and everything, or if I just want to bronze up my skin or whatever. Yeah, I really like this palette. Of course, I've hit pan with it. So yeah, I definitely like that palette. I can't wait to try their new bronzing palettes or contour palettes and everything. Because I was going to stop using e.l.f. Here's one of e.l.f.'s blush palettes, which is in Pink Passion. And this one I've hit pan and the glass kind of like fell out as well. And that's what you could see there. Yeah, I really hit pan with that. You could tell. And I was like, this is pretty like for spring and for summer looks. And I'm probably gonna need another one or a new one with much better blush packaging. Next one we go with foundations or primer first. This one is by Rimmel London, which is Stay Matte Primer. And that, oh my gosh, it was like you put this on and you put on your primer or your foundation, it stays on like all day. Does not come off until you take it off. So yeah, this one says use alone or under or over makeup. I'm like, why put it over makeup? You already got, you know, foundation on and everything. So yeah, I ran out of this too. So I was like, I need to try the other primer for the one foundation I'm about to show y'all. And here's the Stay Matte as well. Liquid Mousse Foundation in Soft Beige. And that... this one I really, really loved. And that lightweight, shine control. If I don't want to look, you know, too shiny, too dewy or whatever. Which I think I'm going to try and start doing. Get like the dewy kind because my skin is so dry. So, no more mattes for me. Okay. This other Rimmel London Lasting Finish 25 Hour with Comfort Serum. and it has SPF 20 sunscreen, which I really like, and also in Soft Beach and that. Y'all can see there. And I haven't really used this up yet, so I got a long time. Plus, it has 1/4 ounce in that, so it's a skin perfecting full coverage foundation, which I totally like. And here's the other Maybelline. I'm always reaching for this. This is the nude kind, 40 nude airbrush finish. This gives you such a flawless finish, let me tell you. And that, trying to get it to the bottom, and that, because you could tell I got plenty of left in there. Yeah, it's kind of like what? And yeah, I'll still reach for this probably when it gets by spring and summertime. Yeah, okay. This e.l.f. Flawless Finish Foundation, I know everybody has been raving about this e.l.f. product as well, which I used to love this e.l.f. foundation probably last year. In that, and it's 15 SPF 15 oil free, which I totally like because I don't want to be too oily and be like, you know, breaking out or whatever. And it helps prevent sunburn, which I totally like. And that I need to find me more foundation with SPF and that, because when you go out in the sun, that sun is gonna damage your skin. Okay, next is concealers. I have one that's by Rimmel London, which I've already used up. You can see here. And that, which is the Hide the Blemish Concealer. It's corrector anti whatever. Yeah, I used this up like 2 years ago, and I just kept it so I can show it to y'all. Ain't I nice? I show y'all stuff that I used to use a long time ago. And this is the Revlon Photo Ready. Oh my gosh. This one I totally fell in love with. I'll have to show y'all the video that I did 2 years ago when I was doing the Valentine's Day look, and I used this with it. So if y'all like to see that video, because I know Valentine's gonna be coming up around the corner. My God, this month is going by so fast. My goodness. So, I've already used this up as well, which I can't go up anymore. And now, which you can see there. And it's in light. And Rimmel London was also a neutralizer. That was like 2-on-1 for Rimmel. And this is Revlon, which is 002, light pale. Which I wasn't really as pale 2 years ago, and not. Okay. Let's go with some brush cleaner, shall we? First, when I first bought brush cleaners, I used this constantly in between the doing my makeup, and I totally loved it. So I went ahead and got me a backup of it, which both of them are completely out and that. So, but look at the detail. This one, when they've just first started coming out, and this one, you know, has a little brush on it, which I thought was really, really cute and different. And I need to get me some new brush cleaners, but I would like to have a big brush cleaner. Maybe if I could find something that I could make my own brush cleaner. Okay, the next one I would show this eyelash curler. Everybody loves eyelash curler, right? This one's pretty old, so I already got two new ones. So, and I also have one that I have not even touched yet, which is eyelash heated curler. Yeah, so I have not used it yet. So it's like, why do I have it? I don't know. So yeah, it's been a pretty good eyelash curler, as I would say. Okay, next one. I mentioned this in my eyes video, even though it's not really for eyes, but it's for eyebrows and that. And it's in the color Taupe and that. When I tried using the the medium brown, I thought it was just a little bit too dark for my skin tone. So I went ahead and just stick with taupe because I love it. Okay, dark circles. You know how everybody hates dark circles? I know I do. See? And that, so I got the kind in medium, which is kind of like an orange color, as you can see here. And you just, if you have, really bad dirt bags, you just put under your eyes like so. And this is what the color looks like. I don't know if you could probably see it. I'm gonna try to swatch it on my hand. I did a video of this as well, and I'll put in the links in the iCards up here somewhere, I guess here. And this is what it looks like. You can barely tell right there. And you just use your ring finger, and I just lightly, go over it, and it kind of hides the nasty dark circles on your eye bags. Okay, another thing with eyes, I love this mascara, which is L'Oreal. I've got stuff all over it, Voluminous Carbon Black by L'Oreal, and that. Love the brush on it, and that. Here's what the brush looks like, and that. Very, very soft on the eyes and everything, and that. I'll try to get close as I can get it. See? Yeah, I totally love this brush. It gives you so much volume, so much the length and everything. So yeah, I totally love this mascara. Okay, this stuff I always love nude. Something nude, I'm always going like for light makeup looks and everything. And this one, I was like, I had to get it, and it's in the color salmon, like salmon, like the food that I love to eat, and it's kind of like to do with fish and everything. But really, it's kind of like a pretty, to me, it's more like a nude pinky color. And I'm gonna swatch it here for you. It's really, really glittery. It's like, if you don't really need like so much glitter and everything, there you go. I mean, look at that. That's just so beautiful, ain't it? Oh my gosh. And that is so pretty. And that, so that's in salmon. Pretty color, just to, go on top of the eyes and everything. If you just want a little, glamour-ish to the eye look or whatever. You could probably go with any eye color too, and that really make the eyes stand out. Okay, I'm gonna get with I was talking about glitter with that one, but these, oh my gosh, these babies here, which I have not all the shades. I have about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have 8 shades for right now, and the first one I'm going to show y'all is called Gunmetal, which is kind of like a. Let's see if I can show y'all without the glare. It's kind of like a gunmetal in that color. Maybe if I take off the lid, I can show y'all. Yeah, it looks like that. That's what gunmetal looks like. It's kind of like a silvery black in between. And it's really pretty, like if you have like maybe dark eyeshadow look and everything. You pop this in the middle. Oh my gosh, it's so pretty. And that next one I have is gold, which is like good for like, I don't know, Valentine's or maybe like for New Year's or something. And that here's gunmetal and everything. I'll show you, I mean not gunmetal, gold. Why am I saying gunmetal? Here's gold. That's what gold looks like. Okay. Usually sometimes you get it everywhere, but that's why I have a NYX glitter primer for it. It comes in a little tube, and that you just put a little bit, on your finger, on your eyes, and you just apply whatever glitter you want, and it goes on beautifully. And the next color I have is blue. And that. Do blue whenever you want to. Oh, this allergy. Here's what blue looks like. See that? Oh my gosh, look at that. Whoops! I'm about to get it on my bed. Oopsie! Oh well, if you get wash, it'll be fine. Alright, that's blue. Here's red. The color red. I'm gonna try not to dip it out as much. I like to see if they can, if they have like rose. Yeah, this is red. Isn't that pretty? Okay, that's red. This one's my favorite one. I just bought like last year in that, and I totally love this color, which is copper. And that looks like an orange color. Here's copper. Try and get as close as I can. And here is teal, which is kind of like a green color. You can do like for St. Patrick's Day or whatever. Here's teal. Here's what teal looks like. And that. I wish I could just like show it to you like differently. This one's a crystal. You can tell it's kind of like a confetti crystal-ish. And that, I'll take the lid off. So I'm gonna show it to y'all. This is what crystal looks like. Very, very glittery. It has all kinds of different colors. Blue, pink, purple, green. Oops! And I'm getting on my bed again. And here is ice. And very, very white eyeshadow or eye glitter. And that. Here's ice. You can barely see it. And yeah, those are easy to put on everything. And if you don't like too much glitter, and now you can always get the like little brush kinds and that. But yeah. Oh god, my nose. This weather. Keep on changing. Oh my god. Well, that completes my makeup for Best of Beauty of 2016 that I have been loving the past year. And if you like this video, give it a like. And I'm sorry it was a long video because I had a lot of shit to show y'all. Like I said. And but tomorrow will be easier because it's all about the lips and everything. I don't have that many lip products to show y'all tomorrow. So, hope y'all be ready to see that one. And that, and yeah. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button before you leave. And click on the notify bell button so you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video. And that, so I hope y'all have a great day. Stay warm, stay safe, and okay, I'll see y'all tomorrow.